Now I'm coming back to a more nuts and bolts topic. My name is Andreas Zucker. I work for the, can you hear me? Yeah? Oh. All right. For the, a unit called Knowledge for the Energy Union at the DGJRC. My presentation will have, I will talk about two subjects, about models and about data. First, starting with models. From a JRC perspective, what is driving us? First of all, some facts. We have more than 100 models running at the Joint Research Center. About 200 experienced modelers are working on those models. And more than half of our models are used for impact assessments of the European Commission. Of course, far beyond the energy field. Energy is just one of the activities of the JRC. There is agriculture and many other activities. What does it mean and what are the consequences? Well, the challenges currently are, of course, that the policy of the European Commission to improve the transparency of impact assessments and the quality of those has led to a, I would say, positive pressure to improve our awareness of our models and also the documentation of those and to establish own policies for producing better models that address the questions that have just been asked about openness. For this purpose, the JRC has institutionalized this effort but in creating a competence center of modeling, which has started its work this year. It is a JRC internal activity, but I think increasingly the world outside will get in contact with our competence center and will learn more about it. Today I'm going to say just a few things about it, given the limited amount of time I'm given. Now, what is the purpose of a competence center on modeling? It is to promote a responsible use of models, to increase the quality, consistency of models, and to improve efficiency of modeling. Efficiency meaning we have once you have 200 people working on modeling, there is easily a tendency to duplications or, inefficient structures. Cannot tell you spend too much time on this, but maybe I give you an idea about what the colleagues working on that have been doing in the past years. And this is to, first of all, understand the inventory of models that has developed in the Joint Research Center over the last years. And with nowadays, we are in a lucky position to have software that helps us to visualize things. So what has been done? Not only the models have been inventorized, but the models, the data those models use, the impact assessments and policies for which those models have been applied, and of course the expert working on these models, and of course studies and presentations and scientific publications. All this has been put in one big database and has been linked, so that it is now possible easily for the competence center on modeling, but for anyone using this system to understand and to visualize very easily how different model families are connected and what has been used for which purpose. And you can easily see clusters around data sets, around models and families of models, but also islands maybe of models. If you see an island, you might wonder if this has a particular reason. This tool is, I'm going to jump over the slides. The following slides show you some visualizations that you can actually show, but given the time, I will skip a little bit. What is more important for us is for you is to know that the competence center will actually open this tool in future so that outside JRC users can have a better idea and have more access and that there is more transparency about what JRC is doing. And by the way, this MIDAS repository is not limited to JRC anymore, but to commission models in general. This is all I'm going to say about meters and the competence center of modeling for today. There will be no announcements on this during the year 2017. Yes, we're discussing with stakeholders how to make all this available. Big effort from our colleagues. Now something even more nuts and bolt data, but maybe important, I would say. What are the challenges? The challenges are, of course, that Joint Research Center wants to meet and wants to accommodate the wish for open access. This is a decision of the Commission. The prominent one you have I've shown on the slide, 2011. Now, if a commission decides to make data open, this of course has to be implemented somehow. And JRC has taken some time to actually implement that decision and to create a management plan. Has been addressed, and now documents result in more documents, that's inevitable. So the answer to that was the JRC developed a data policy. There's a document everybody can download, and that document actually explains what I'm going to show on the next slide. And this, I think, to a degree also maybe meets what Tom suggested me to present. So when we are faced with a request or with a wish to open data, to make this transparent, we first, an important point is to understand what kind of data we have. And at the JSC, but everywhere, you typically have three situations. Data can be either produced by you, it could be produced by you in collaboration with somebody else, or it could have been acquired from a third party. And even if the data has been produced by you, it doesn't mean it's free of third party data. It can be based on data sets that have been provided by third parties. Now, in order to understand what conditions for reuse I could grant to somebody else, I first have to identify very well in which category I am. And of course, I will rarely be in one of the three precisely, but often in combinations of those, because it is also a data set could have dependencies, 20 dependencies on additional data sets. What would happen? So in case we have a data set that we have produced on our own, it's rather easy, we share that. So there is a we will attach a license to that, and this license will allow you to use this this data set, provided you respect our copyright notice that you do not claim that it is your own. But otherwise, this is the most simple case, and apart from a very few exceptions, this is the way to go. Now, often, of course, the situation is slightly more complicated because the data set might be depending on a third-party data set. Now, this third-party data set often comes with very different license conditions. So what we actually do there is we have to analyze the third-party licenses and potentially negotiate with them. This is something some people have asked me before. This is something which I am doing for the last few months for a model that we use internally based on the times model generator, where we first have to understand third-party data licenses before making any decisions of sharing the model with somebody else. Of course, the aim is to negotiate a license with a third-party supplier or an agreement that we can then share the derived data set. That is always our goal. But first, it's a complication. And then, of course, the situation that also inevitably occurs is that whole parts of your input data, your model input data, could have been acquired from third parties under commercial conditions. Now, in this case, it all boils down to negotiations with third parties. of course, maybe there are alternatives, and maybe also the this initiative, this EMP-E platform, could help create data sets that would allow us to avoid the usage of third-party commercial data sets. But might not always be a given, but certainly would facilitate our world. So I hope I have just given you a little bit of insight into the complexity we are faced with when deciding to open a model or a data set. We have a legal service working on that. And I can assure you that the colleagues working in this legal service are quite busy with this kind of requests. But any data set we publish, I have published two data sets in the last year, are published with a license, and whenever we can, this license is as open as possible. Am I still on time? Yeah, maybe. Very good. last thing, we have a data catalog. We released the first version last year. What is this data catalog? It's, of course, a website. It's in the intracom and within the JRC, but now within the commission. It has been opened commission-wide. It is possible to identify and to look up for data sets. What is important about this data catalog, it's not only a website. It is also a data sets get unique identifiers, so it allows us to have, and these are persistent, so it allows us to run modeling exercises with precisely identified data set. There's quite some work behind that. It sounds obvious at first sight, but there's much more behind that to make this possible, to ensure really that when a JRC researcher uses a data set, that we can assure that this data set and not a variant of that has been used. The data catalog, there are two versions, of course. There is an internal version, but there is also external version. So for those of you who might not be familiar with our data sets, you can have a look at the following websites. There you will see both the data catalogs and the EU open data portal, and there is also a European data portal supplied by the member state. We expect that all these activities will grow in the following years, and we are very interested in receiving feedback from you. Thank you very much.
Keeping to the tight timing. We have time for two or three questions. Could you raise your hand if you have a question, and then someone with a microphone. So it's number one, Joseph. Any other questions? Yeah. And Barrett, number two. Francesca Barrett, in the front. Yeah.
Dawna Chokani from ETH Zurich. To what extent are your data sets standardized?
Okay, let's take the second question as well. All right.
Okay, I think this is a data portal as far as I understand. I don't know, is it a database? So my question is, there are several databases emerging all over the world with open data. Like, how can we work together with the databases? Because we are in a group who are also developing a database with like modeling features, that there's an API and there's revisions and so on, and we would really like to exchange data that the open data of the different databases which are emerging could be exchanged. And I think we have to agree about metadata and things of that. It would be really interesting to have a working group on that. Tomorrow there's a working group. Will you still be there for the open database working group? That would be really interesting to talk about that a little bit more.
My question goes to the same direction. Thank you, Barrett. Because the URI indicates that you're working on linked open data. Is that right, that you're trying to make your database standardized for linked open data? Because this is what we try to work on, the 5 stars of open data, to get all database projects that are emerging in the European Union and in the world to connect the databases, that we don't create islands of data and we have the same problems that we have now, that you have isolated data sets all over the places.
I would first say thank you very much. Thank you very much for the suggestions. First of all, we follow our data policy. This is our guidance, and this data policy is a result of a commission policy. Regarding the standardization, the situation here is that form follows function. So the driver is, and the data sets have a long history, so standardization depends. As I would say, this really depends on the model and the modeling family. You have to understand we have a bandwidth from modeling of environmental systems, hydrogeology, geology, GIS data, and these different communities might have different standards. I mean, this is what I understand the question. Maybe I did not understand your question quite right, but I would say that the different data sets used at the JRC or in the commission could have very come from different modeling communities. So, and those communities, and first of all, our own policy sets any requirements. This is so a linkage to other initiatives is something. Yes, which you have to apologize that I cannot answer this right now. So, of course, we are interested in that, and of course, the job of the Joint Research Center and of a unit that is called Knowledge for the Energy Union, and we have a whole directorate for knowledge management now, is exactly to link to those initiatives. So I think that's all I want to say from the side of a JRC. So of course our job is actually to know what other people are doing, not only to do things on our own. That is very important. Whether how to formalize that, I think, is a process, and I believe that this event here is actually a very good place to start. Of course, don't forget there is also Patrick and DGRTD, who are willing to, I understand, support these activities. And they might operationally play or financially play a bigger role than we do, because our financial, of course, possibilities that the JRC might not always meet some of the ideas that the open modeling community has. So I have to say that we are limited there. But it doesn't mean nothing will happen. And the third question, I'm not aware of your concrete initiative there.
It's not an initiative, it's based on the wiki database project that we connect databases using URIs, and to identify and standardize formats to connect different databases and data sets in a formalized way.
And your question is whether our own unique identifiers follow this standard?
Yes.
Yes. I can come back to you. I can come back to you. This is a good question for answering offline. Please send me an email. I'll ask the competent colleague. Yeah.
Thank you very much, Andreas. That was terrifically useful.